Right. Welcome back to Guild of Gaming and Xenoblade Chronicles Definitive Edition. We're 12 hours in, we're on Bahamas' leg, and we've got a little boy to save, and an entire species to genocide. It's gonna be a busy night, right? Alright. Oop. Heart to heart. I don't think we can do this one. Nope. Did we talk to everybody? I don't know if we talked to everybody inside last night. Let's just do a quick once-over.
Hello?
Friends already forgot what Sitata needs? Okay, yeah, you got that quest already. Stick away with Vibers. We're on it. I feel like we talked to people in here already. Let's go out and do some quests. Speaking of quests, let's see what we got. Alright, just current. Mementos of a Lost Sun. Let's do a quick check to see if we see that on the map. No obvious blue. Yeah, right there. One of those mementos is over there. Keep that in mind. We're not going to track it right now. Let's see. We need to get our friendship up. Dark Mercamore. Oh, that was back at the other. Okay, let's go to Bonus Leg quests here. Alright. What do these ones with the clock on them mean? Does that mean we have a limited time to take care of them, maybe? Didn't we have one with a clock on it from Colony 9? I don't see it anymore. I think those might be like limited time quests, maybe. We need to do these first. Alright. Let's get out there and do all these quests with the clock on it before we advance the main story anymore, because I don't know how far we have to go before suddenly they don't become available.
What is it?
I'm assuming that's what that means, because there's no time limit on those quests. The last time I saw one of those on there, it was a quest that was like, you need to do this at nighttime, and I thought that's what that meant. But these don't have any kind of thing like that. So now I'm thinking the clock must be like, it's missable, basically. Can't have that. Alright. We can't really zoom this. Let's head out into the right a bit. At those ether detecting monsters up there. Alright, what we got here? These guys. Let's do it.
The enemy's weak.
Get this pot of stuff. Knock them down. You know, I was thinking about it last night. It might actually be easier to play as Rhyme because a lot of people have a lot of different ways to break people, but Rhyme is like the only one with topple, and we're at his mercy to use it to make the topple actually happen. I feel like it would be a lot easier to accomplish topple if we were controlling Rhyme, and then as soon as someone broke it, which would happen a lot more often, we could, you know, manually topple them. And I'm considering switching to playing as him for a bit. Just because, you know, you can't really control the other party members all the time. But he toppled that guy. Maybe we should try playing as Rhyme for a little bit. It would also be making us the person who's trying to hold aggro and stuff, which would also probably, like, all in all, it just seems like a thing to do to make some of our party management woes easier. Not that we're having trouble at the moment, but also I just feel like we should try other characters out. So, Rhyme. Let's check out your abilities. Right. That's awesome. Alright. We've got several. We don't even have them all on. We have a sword drive ability. Stab an enemy dealing a large amount of damage. That is a large amount of damage. War swing does a pitiful damage, but it hits a bunch of people and fills the talent gauge. a lot of his abilities are centered around filling the talent gauge so he can keep taunting, right? His job isn't to do damage, as nice as that ability is, although he does have a minute and a half cooldown, something else to keep in mind. His job is not to do damage, his job is to hold aggro and topple people. So we definitely want Wild down. Speaking of toppling people, does anybody else have a green ability? Yeah, no one else can topple right now. So, like, control of Wild down seems, like, super important, I feel like. So I think we're going to have to go for that. All right, so let's see what we've got going on here. We've got... he's open to block attacks. It's an Aether ability. It's a 40-second cooldown. It blocks all physical attacks for 12 seconds, but we can't move or auto-attack during it. So, I mean, that's literally just going to defense mode. That could be good if there's, like, a big hit coming, right? Aura Burst. Available when aura is when an aura is active. Attack reduces enemy strength. Only available with aura active. Do we have an aura? Yes, rage is an aura. Okay, and engage is an aura. Okay, so these orange ones are auras. We also have Berserker. Aura that disregards defense to prioritize attack. Auto attack and mad taunt area effect. Strength up 75%. What? But defense down 25%. That's a pretty big net gain though, right? Interesting. What does Aura Burst do? So it reduces the strength of enemies around me by 25% for 10 seconds. And accumulates aggro. Okay. So like basically I guess when an aura is about to end, pop it off for an extra buff there, maybe. So Wild down has a 22-second cooldown right now. The rage is physical damage down 25%, spike damage, and attack power down. So it lowers... this is an aura that's lowering the stats of the enemies around us, right? Range is an individual target. It's an aura, but it only affects one target. Does that work? Engage aura that greatly raises aggro, drawing enemy attention. Good. Mad taunt aggro increases 1.25%, so 25% extra mad taunt. Mad taunt is our talent, right? Yeah. Taunt an enemy, drawing aggro, and becoming the enemy target. Talent gauge must be maxed. It accumulates aggro. We can't actually level that one up, can we? Maybe we can, unless it would be over here. We can't unequip it. No, I don't see it. Alright, if we work on Wild down, it'll lower the cooldown a little more, but not much. War Swing. Range, circle around the user. Distance close, a little bit of damage, minute cooldown. Multiple hits to enemy enraged. It fills the talent gauge. Okay. So you basically use it to AoE. It does pitiful damage. Although maybe we can work on that. Not much. It does not very much damage. But it fills the talent gauge up, basically. We can taunt again. Doing this just lowers the cooldown, pretty much. Well... this just works on the cooldown and the effect time for all of these. Oh, increases the strength buff. Dang. Okay. A lot of these are just cooldown and effect time. I'm gonna have to try them out before I decide which ones to really focus on. Alright. We got a little bit of an idea of how he works. Let's try him out in practice. We're giving up control of the Monado. Have more control over other parts of our fight. We'll see if that works out for us. Alright. We're still looking for some more of these collectibles, too. I need to check next time we're back in the town to check all the named NPCs to see if maybe some of them sell collectibles we might be missing. Although we don't know the names of the collectibles we're missing. Think of it. Darby's Berry. Alright, let's try... Okay, back off. Let's not try that. Guy is, surprisingly high level. What's that up there? That cave right there, right? Is this the next cave that the guy told us to check, where he told us to check for the infinite thing? So these daughter armors are weak, but like, these red ones, oh my god, they're level 77.
This will be a breeze.
Okay, let's sort this out nice and quickly.
Don't get careless, guys! Quick learning abilities. Hammer beat, temporarily increases aggro.
Alright, we can do it.
Looks like it's no problem.
Eat this, bone!
Thunderbullet!
We can definitely do this!
Sharp as a nail, Shulk.
Yeah, we have to work on that a lot. That's okay. We'll figure it out. I'm just gonna figure out the best way to use these different abilities. Hey Echo, welcome to the stream. Punctual today. I'm trying out our tank here. Trying to see if maybe using him will make it easier to do the toppling and everything, since he's the only person with the topple ability. And also, I mean, right now I suck at it, but once I get used to it, it might be good to manage the aggro.
Okay, let's sort this out nice and quickly.
Monado, save us from harm!
Thunderbullet!
Last seen the Monado in action.
Now!
Suck on this!
I'm powering up!
I'm never gonna give up.
Don't mess with the best!
Round to a pulp.
Okay, let's get going.
I think I want to kind of rearrange his abilities on his bar a little bit. I've got a named guy here. Let's see if we can lure some of the little ones away from him. No, they're gonna get all three. Alright, let's engage so we can draw aggro. Topple. We got pretty solid aggro, I feel like. Need to keep an eye on how long these auras last so I can do like this spore burst. Thing, which is this one?
Bring it on! We've got a good
not long now.
You don't need to tell me.
Suck on this!
Only downside of this is that I don't do the damage.
I'm turning up the heat. You're really getting
oh, what the?
Right.
What's that? Top of the sky.
It's just a matter of time now.
Suck on this.
Fire!
Bastard! Yeah. All together now. Now it's right time. Bring it on.
Fire!
Suck on
this. Make a lot of friends here.
Oh yeah, baby.
Rhyme. Rhyme time. That's exactly right.
We've got all right. I'm feeling it. Eat this. Gain this, Shulk.
Sharp as a nail, Shulk.
Come on.
Beat this.
You're not good enough, Shulk.
Show him.
Everyone, let's go.
Bad time. I'm gonna end up being just as bad at doing this as he is.
Yeah, we got him.
Golem.
Okay, let's
go. Oh, we got golem. The named guys seem to always drop the gold chest, that's cool. Okay. We got a weapon for her. Maybe. See. Well, that's just a big upgrade. We lose one slot, but like gain 70 to 80 damage. I think we can make do. We can drop the HP, I think. Take the muscle up. Which is basically like defense, I believe. Hunter gear. More overall defense. I wish you could make it to where when you switch, that was an enemy chain attack. That's cool. That's the first time I've seen an enemy do a chain attack. I wish you could do it to where like when you switch equipment, it just automatically pops the gem out of the old one and puts it in the new one. That makes sense. Like if I could just be like, you know, lock. Does that work? Let me try this. If I lock that in there, and then do this, yeah, it still goes away. Where was that? Look at those pants, man. Those glowy pants. Alright, so there's a muscle up two in there. Find that. Carry attire. I'll say brigadine, so that's way more defense. We would get a recovery up to, which is increase HP restored when healed. I mean, that's not bad. Versus our HP up to, which is 10% HP to begin with. But also getting 20 more physical defense out of the deal. We could see. And we could swap this one, get us back our HP up 12%. This one doesn't have a slot, otherwise it'd be pretty nice for the most part. Alright. Let's check out the others. Monado is the Monado, and it's always going to be the Monado. he can say the way he is, I think. Her, we got her a weapon finally. It's unique, but Aether up 3 is not bad for her. And the damage difference, like, hell yeah. Alright, get her some other equipment. Well, mostly I just want the slots. Blaze defense. I mean, it's something. Sure. I'll take less defense for a slot. Give her an Aether defense, I don't know. Give her some of these random ones. For now. I don't really have really good gems for her, I don't think. Nothing else obvious over here. And there's more guys I could fight. But no obvious reason to. Don't see any more blue orbs down here either. Always like to look for the blue orbs when I get to a new area because although they are random, I wonder if maybe some of them might be only in certain areas, you know? And I don't mean like the Bionis' leg, I mean like an area like this particular part of the Bionis' leg, you know?
This will be a breeze.
Okay, let's sort this out nice and quickly.
Don't get careless, guys. Love seeing the Monado in action. Man didn't even break a sweat.
Let's stay alert.
Piece of cake.
Okay. Let's see. We do have some over here we should probably take care of since they're like back towards the like the western side is like the lower level side, I feel like. Or it's at least the side that we came to first. So let's clear out the west side first. Watch out for these level 77 guys. Just jump in the water. Some orbs down here anyways. Rusty Bolt. Hill Firefly, that might be new. So, how much do you know about this game, Echo? One more bug and one more strange. I wish there was a quicker way to switch characters, like just like Bright Bumper or something. The only way to switch characters, I think, is to go into the menu and move them around in the party order. Another thing I was thinking about, if I start a chain attack, is Ryan gonna go first? Because he's in the first slot of the party. Because I don't want Ryan to go first, because he has topple and I need someone to break something first. And if I ever want to like use a chain attack to force like a topple or a daze or something, I can't do that if Ryan goes first. Because if the thing isn't already broken, like he has topple. He's the only person with topple. I feel like the break, topple, daze thing is super important to becoming good at this combat system. There's a lot of other stuff going on too, but that seems like the simple thing that they drill into your head at the beginning. And like, even like, if you're trying to deal with like, Mechon, even without the Monado, it's like, well, if you topple them, you basically ignore their defense so you can still hurt them, you know? Ooh, we got a red item. Those are quest items. How's my mic sound tonight, Echo? Is it, like compared to the game sound and everything? Look at this. Is this like a grave? What is this? Huh. And these level 70 guys just like in the packs. Interesting. Oh crap. By the sound of that music, I'm worried that it was level 70. It doesn't look like it is. That music kicked up and I was like, shoot. Alright, it's just these guys. I can deal with these guys.
Go for this one! Understood.
Gotcha!
Oh, that's too slow on the topple.
You want a piece of me?
My heart is getting hotter.
Ha!
Well, this guy's actually named. Or no, or he's not. He's got like the special thing. Like his name is just Sniper or whatever, so I don't know if that's like actually unique. It seems like it might be. Missed the break there. Top of it, get back up in some time. Right, there's the top one. Oh, I missed it. Okay. Yeah, cool. Yeah, he was so unique, it looks like. Sounds good? That's great. Thank you. I tweaked the settings a little bit. I didn't like the way it sounded last time. Phalanx. Double attack 10% of the time. Higher max attack, lower min. A little bit more defense. We lose our muscle up in favor of 10% double attack. I mean, I'm not against that at the moment. Let's try it out. Alley-oop. Alright. Let's go ahead and teleport back over here. We'll start heading for those other ones. Been working on getting all this up on YouTube. The Xenoblade videos have been more popular than my other ones, mostly because people are actually searching for Xenoblade right now because it just came out, I guess. But trying to get these up. They'll probably all be up tomorrow. Catch YouTube up with the stream. How's Sharla? What about Sharla? She's my healer. She's my white mage. I mean, she's just like any other white mage. Except she has a freaking sniper rifle, which I'm not gonna complain about that. That seems like it could only possibly make her cooler. She heals you by shooting you in the back with a bullet, apparently. I guess. Somehow. I haven't tried her out though. I might in a little bit. I think we're gonna try out the other characters tonight. Don't get careless, guys. Everyone, now I'm really feeling it. Sure, that's good. Wow, sound. Is that all you got? Okay, let's get going. Cool. Doing all the side stuff really makes you a lot more powerful than the stuff around you. Look at this guy. He's only level 32. We can't fight him yet, but we're not super far off. We're gonna come back for that guy. Let's grab this one first, I think. I feel like playing Sharla would mostly just be kind of hanging back, shooting every now and then, and waiting to like get rid of debuffs or heal if needed. You know, she's a support role, for sure. Now, maybe she gets more abilities later. I could let her be more of a mage role or something, because she does have like a lightning ability. Maybe she can expound on those kind of abilities, but I think she's definitely designed to be kind of like a white mage type. Chest. Let's keep on going like this, guys. Piece of cake. Okay. Any arms. Alright, we got our gooseberries. Where do we go from here with those? I don't know. We'll figure that out in a little bit. So it looks like a lot of those marks up here were gooseberry marks, actually, because they all just disappeared. I only got two more red spots on the map. Let's head for the one to the north.